A very pleasant morning, students. Today we shall discuss a new topic, bacteria. Before coming to its economic importance, we know bacteria causes diseases, but yet they also are economically important. So before coming to the topic, let us discuss what is bacteria. We have already studied bacteria belongs to the kingdom group Monera. They are found everywhere except fire, snowbound regions, salt region, halophytes and all. Got it? Then what do we find? That is, when we talk about monerals, bacteria belong to the group kingdom Monera. What are Monera? What are the characteristic features? They are unicellular. They are prokaryotic. Clear? Now, mode of nutrition, both. They show autotrophic mode of nutrition or heterotrophic. Under heterotrophic, what are they? They can be saprophytic, they can be parasitic. Saprophytic. Or parasitic. That means they can live as parasites or saprophytes. Now, when we talk about mode of reproduction, how they reproduce, by asexual method, asexual reproduction, common method, the most common method is binary fission. So we shall discuss each point one by one. I repeat it again. Bacteria belongs to the kingdom Monera. According to Whittaker, how many kingdoms were there? 5 kingdoms. But later on, Carl Ruiz has further divided into 6 kingdoms. But when we talk about Whittaker, he grouped into all the living organisms into 5 kingdoms: Kingdom Monera, Kingdom Protista, Kingdom Fungi, Kingdom Plantae, Kingdom Animalia. So the first group of living organism that existed on this earth planet were the Monerans. This present form of bacteria, when you go to higher classes, you will study that they are called as present forms, eubacteria. The earlier forms are still present. They are called as archaebacteria. So Monera are again divided into archaebacteria, old primitive bacteria, and the present form eubacteria or trobacteria. Clear? Now unicellular, you already know the bacteria are made up of one cell. The nucleus is not well defined, no nuclear membrane, no nucleus and nucleoplasm. That's why they are said to be prokaryotic in nature. Some of the bacteria can prepare their own food. What are those? Cyanobacteria. Clear? Now, as I said earlier, autotrophic means what? Auto means cell. So, under this, we have the example of cyanobacteria. What are they called? Blue green algae. They are not algae, but they are given the name as blue green algae. This type of bacteria can prepare their own food. Clear? Then we have the example Nostoc, Anavena. These are come under bacteria which can prepare their own food. Heterotrophic bacteria, those bacteria which cannot prepare their own food, so they live in the body of the living organisms for their food. Such forms are called as parasitic bacteria. You have Salmonella bacteria and all. Then you have saprophytic bacteria, that is bacteria which are also called as decomposers. They live by surviving on the dead remains of plants and animals. Some bacteria also live symbiotically, like Rhizobium bacteria. Then you have anaerobic bacteria that can survive in absence of oxygen, called Strigidium. So let us group bacteria into different forms. What are those? You have bacteria can be divided, a group, into different types on the basis of their shape. On the basis of the shape, bacteria are grouped into four types. First is the coccus. Second is bacillus. Third is what? Spirillum or spiral. And fourth is comma shape. Now when we talk about the first type, coccus or cocci, it means round shaped bacteria. So bacteria which are round shaped, they are called as coccus. If they are present in two, they are called as diplococcus. This is monococcus. Then you have bacteria that coccus form in chains when they are referred as streptococcus. Here, bacteria when they are found in chains. Then you have bacteria found in clusters, group, when they are called as staphylo, S-T-A-P-H-Y-L-O, staphylococcus. Example of this coccus, the disease Diplococcus pneumoniae, D-I-P-L-O-C-O-C-U-S, Diplococcus pneumoniae. Okay. So, you have this first form of bacteria, that is the coccus, and the second type is called as bacillus. What is bacillus? Broad shape. Okay? So, let me discuss about the next type, bacillus. Bacillus means what? Broad shape. This again can be present singly, or it can be more than one. They may possess flagella or they may not possess flagella. So, rod shaped bacteria are referred as bacillus. Clear? What are the examples? Lactobacillus, the bacteria that can convert milk into curd. Rhizobium bacteria, which is a symbiotic bacteria, that also is a rod-shaped bacteria. So, this bacteria which are rod-shaped, they are referred as bacillus bacteria. Clear? Now, the next third type is comma-shaped. So, we shall be discussing about the next of the shapes of bacteria in the next class. So for today, remember that what are the different shapes of bacteria, how they are grouped, the characteristic features of kingdom.
That's all. Stay home.